Hello and welcome to the Netherlands. We are in Utrecht for the second time ever. We also came in 2019, back in 2020 at the Central Studios, a very intimate, small venue where the fans do not have a bad seat in this entire venue, alongside the former Glory Welterweight Champion of the World, Joseph Valtellini. My name is Todd Grisham. It feels great to be back in the saddle, doesn't it?
Absolutely, man. I miss calling the fights. Our last one we called was Rico Bader 2, so, I mean, I'm excited to be back with the stacked card that we have tonight.
Yeah, we've got 11 total fights for the next few hours. Let's show you exactly what you have coming. We start with our prelims that you're seeing right here on Pluto TV, YouTube, or even on UFC Fight Pass.
Yeah, one of the fighters that we want to watch here is Antonio Campoy. You know, very experienced, very flashy with his kicks. So if you give him some space, expect some spectacular offense.
And on the left there, Lorena Klein is making her Glory debut, and she promises an electrifying entrance. We'll see what she has in store for us. Then coming up at the top of the hour, it's our Glory 75 Super Fight Series. That's at 1 p.m. Eastern time, five fights in all, including one that we really think will get this crowd riled up, that being Garrick Belay and Artur Saladin.
Yeah, you got to think, Belay is a forward pressure fighter, good power, and he always goes to finish. And in Swadiak's last fight, we know he can take some big punishment, but he's got a lot of improvements, and he wants to showcase it in this fight tonight.
As you probably know, we are the world's premier stand-up fighting organization. Look at the combined record of the numbers in the Super Fight Series. 360 wins, 52 losses, 149 combined knockouts, and we scour the globe for the best of the best, eight countries represented. And then it's on to Glory 74 or 75 with four fights. It's our main card, and it starts at 3 Eastern.
Yeah, one of the fights right out of the gate that I'm excited for in that welterweight fight, Gregorian versus Jamie Bates. You know, Harut's last fight was against Cedric Doumbé. He lost via knockout, so he's looking forward to come back and climb the ranks again. But that championship fight, we're seeing for the third time, Petch and Adam Chuck are more experienced. Both have improved technically, and I'm expecting a very clean fight in this one.
And this is the third time they faced each other. The first fight, razor close. Yep. Petch Panamrung a little more dominant in his second bout. How does the Ukrainian win here tonight?
Well, I think he's got to go back to that first fight. He was a little bit more aggressive with his boxing, put things in combination a little bit more. So if he can kind of get there, get past Petch's left kick and get inside and do some work, he's got a good chance.
Joe mentioned the last time we saw you and you saw us was in December for Rico Bader 2. Well, guess what? Bader Hari is back. He'll be fighting in Rotterdam on June 20th. And later tonight on this program, we'll tell you who his opponent is. Right now, I'll tell you who the ring announcer is. That's Tim Hughes, and he gets us started.
Good evening, everyone. We welcome you inside this beautiful, intimate setting, inside Central Studios in Utrecht, the Netherlands. Let me hear from you one time, if you can. Are you excited for some kickboxing tonight? It is Glory 75 Utrecht, and we've got 11 fantastic fights on the card tonight, culminating, of course, with five rounds for the Featherweight Championship of the World. The Super Fight Series also will bring the return of Anissa Mexen, looking for her 100th career win. We will get the evening started, however, with two preliminary bouts and two fighters who will be making their Glory debuts in the Women's Super Bantamweight Division. Please welcome to the Glory Ring, Almira Tincherina.
Almira Tincherina, making her Glory and professional debut. What kind of fighter is she?
Well, she comes from a Muay Thai background. She's a gold medalist at the IFMAs in her amateur career. So you know she's got a lot of good experience. And in the IFMAs, they fight a lot of international competition. So she's ready for the big stage.
I have a feeling these two females' entrances are going to be a little bit different.
I agree.
That was Tincherina.
And now please welcome her opponent, Lorena Klein.
You're about to lose it!
Reyna Klein, Lady Pitbull, fighting out of the Netherlands, making her glory debut. And Joe, it's safe to say she is pumped.
Yeah, she came in even in the weigh-in. She got in right into Tinchurina's face. Tinchurina staying calm, didn't want to engage in it, but we got that Pitbull look right now. She's ready to go.
Hey, we know Deontay Wilder got gassed out by his outfit he wore last week. I hope Reyna Klein is still ready to go after that entrance. She's 32 years old, 5'2" with a 60 and a half inch reach. Tinchurina, much taller and much longer. Here are the glory rules. 3 rounds, 3 minutes each. Punches, kicks, and knees are the legal strikes. 3 knockdowns in a round or 4 in the fight results in a TKO.
And the bouts are going to be scored using the following prioritized criteria, starting with knockdowns, followed by cumulative damage inflicted, followed by number of clear and scoring strikes. First with spectacular techniques, followed by normal scoring techniques. Finally, with no clear advantage, judges look for aggression.
Open scoring tonight. 5 judges will score it on a 10-point must system. You will see their scores after each round. Let's look at that entrance again from Reyna Klein. Could you do this, Joe?
I haven't tried. I don't know if I'd want to just before a fight, but I know for that whole entrance, I was headbanging to that house music. Got me hyped up.
Boy, I was pounding this monster energy, I'll tell you that.
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, we are scheduled for 3 3-minute rounds in Glory's Super Bantamweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the black corner. She is a gold medalist at last year's IFMA World Championships. As an amateur, 22 wins with 4 losses, one of those wins coming by way of knockout. She will make her professional and Glory debut tonight. At 5'6" 1/2", 1.69 meters, she weighed in at 119.9 pounds, 54.5 kilos. Fighting tonight out of Russia, ladies and gentlemen, here is Elmira Tinchurina. Here now is her opponent fighting out of the white corner. She began training kickboxing at the young age of just 18. She is a veteran of over 41 professional bouts, 29 wins, 12 losses, 4 of those wins coming by way of knockout. She, too, will make her Glory debut tonight. At 5'2" tall, 1.58 meters, she weighed in at 121.5 pounds, 55.1 kilograms. Fighting tonight out of the Netherlands, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Reyna, the Lady Pitbull, Klein. The referee for this bout, Rafael Girardi.
This is... Okay, this is 40, K1, okay? No elbow. Stop, stop, back, back. Okay, good fight. Please. Judge.
Reyna
Judge.
Klein looks the Judge. Part for sure. Trying to intimidate Elmira Tinchurina, who's making her professional debut tonight. Round 1, scheduled for 3.
So Tinchurina is going to want to use that reach. You see that height advantage, but... Klein all about explosion. No,
Klein with a okay. Superwoman punch.
Fight. She says that's her best technique because it comes from surprises. It closes distance really quickly. But Klein wants to use that Dutch-style head guard to get inside, use her low kicks.
And what's one thing you would tell your fighter to keep in mind as they make their pro debut?
Well, I mean, control the pace. I think a lot of fighters have a lot of extra anxiety, a lot of extra nerves. And even before you step into the ring, your gas tank is already, you know, taken away. So pacing yourself, and especially in this first round, getting comfortable. I think that's a key. But again, with 3 rounds, you kind of can't wait too long.
Body shot there from Klein.
Yep, being the shorter fighter, that's the key. Level changing.
He's trained by Etin Dizalis.
Ooh.
Klein told us she has a different style. You never know which trick I'm going to pull. There's a right hand. She also says, sometimes I will release the pit bull.
I just like the strike variety that Klein's using. We've seen overhand rights. She's attacked the body. We've seen low kicks. So she's finding the strike that works best for her. Where Tinchurina now, we just saw a knee, which is a good strategy. Try to time those knees as Klein enters with that explosion.
Klein says she has a similar fighting style to Anissa Mexen, who we'll see later here tonight in Utrecht. Do you agree with that?
Well, Anissa Mexen is more of a hit and move, good with her distance control, where I think Klein is more of a pressure fighter. So I see Klein more of like a, you know, one of our pressure fighters that we've seen with like a Gregorian style, you know, Haruk Gregorian, Marat, pressure, get inside, ring control.
Can't wait for that fight later tonight. Haruk Gregorian returning to the glory ring for the first time since losing his title about a year ago. He faces United Kingdom's Jamie Bates.
Yeah, Jamie Bates tall. He looked great in his last fight, so I'm excited for that one.
Good combination there from Lady Pitbull.
Yep, I like that straight right to the body.
Good kick from the Russian.
Fight!
Klein back to hitting that body. What she's doing well is she'll hit the body and then she'll go upstairs with that right hand. So she's making Tincherina always guess where she's attacking.
Spinning back fist just misses the mark from Klein. Blood now trickling out of Klein's nose. So a good first round in the professional career of Tincherina, but did she win it, Joe?
No, I think Klein got that win, and the Lady Pitbull, she's, as we've seen, that Superman punch, which you call it, our Superwoman punch. So it's all about explosion for her. I mean, she's been out of the ring a little bit. She just is making her way back, but she's got good momentum going into this fight, and she looked great in that first round. We have Tincherina here. We're talking about her making her pro debut and very successful as an amateur. If you can go in and win the IFMA Worlds, I mean, that's like you're fighting a lot of pro fighters. You do wear gear, but you're facing the best competition in the world. So, I mean, I think she got this first round out of the way. She dealt with that pressure. So hopefully this round she can kind of stick to her strategies and her length, you know, not crashing the distance as much.
We'll just call it a super punch, Joe, and there it is, spot on from the Lady Pitbull.
Yeah, close the distance. Quick, boom. Quick shot, gets inside, then she gets her work in there.
Fight!
Almira Tincherina in the black gloves, Lorena Klein in the white. Tincherina, born in Uzbekistan. Wanted to be an Air Force pilot. As we look at the scores there, four of the five judges gave that to Klein. Said she wanted to be an Air Force pilot, but fell in love with Muay Thai, and here she is.
Yeah, I like Tincherina now. Straight punches, front kicks. Okay, she has to find a way to keep Klein off of her. So she's got to use those long limbs. I like Klein now attacking the back leg of Tincherina.
Well, if you look at the faces, Joe, Klein's already messed up. Tincherina, much less damage.
Yeah, because when you're the shorter fighter, you almost have to fight your way inside. So, I mean, that's why it's an important strategy to be able to move your head off center line.
That's a long way to land a knee for Klein. Tincherina, 5'7", close. Klein, 5'2". Big overhand right for Klein. And then tries it again. Maybe she's found something.
What I like about Klein's footwork, too, is she's making subtle angles with her footwork. So before she attacks, she takes a nice little slight angle, and then she throws her hands. You see her circle out, create an angle, and attack. Because she knows entering straight won't be the best strategy. Takes her time, circles out, and then comes in and attacks. Definitely a better round for Tincherina, but she's making it more difficult for Klein to come in.
1-2 there from Tincherina. Told us that her parents were very hesitant to let their daughter get into the fight game, but eventually they started loving it as much as her, and they're very excited to see her pro debut tonight. She was 22-4 as an amateur.
Maybe Klein used up too much energy in that entrance in that first round. Tincherina's, her ability to remain calm may be favoring her in these last two rounds.
She was like the ultimate warrior from the old WWF days. At the entrance, he would be cast out for the fight starting. That front kick's been there all night for Tincherina.
Yeah, but Klein's attacking that lead leg. She's gone to it many times.
Break. Fight.
This is definitely a closer round. Ooh, back to the body for Klein.
A better round two for Tinchurina, but Klein closing strong. The 2020 season continues next with the Glory Super Fight Series, a light heavyweight showdown. This is Maslojabev taking on Royal Monarch. Also returning number one ranked super bantamweight Anissa Mexen, looking for a career victory. 100, it all comes your way next on the Glory Super Fight Series. Soon see the judges' scorecards.
I wouldn't be surprised if they're split. It was a very close round.
Break.
Break.
Fight!
Whoa. And right hand connects for Klein. May have been her best punch of the night.
Yeah, it seems that every time Klein hits, you can see more physical damage and hear it, but where Tinchurina might be the more active of the two. She's trying to pressure a little bit more, which could be scoring favorably from the judges. Yep, there's that straight punch from Tinchurina. I like it.
Not a lot behind those punches, Joe.
No, but it's more volume-based. Where Klein, when she hits, you can hear the impact more.
Fight!
And you gotta remember, second scoring criteria is damage. You can be the more active fighter, but if I hit you and I'm doing more damage with the shot, I win.
Well, the problem is, as I mentioned earlier, Klein looks like more damage has been inflicted on her face, but she's throwing the harder punches like that right hand.
Yep, those have to score well. You can think you can eat three jabs, but when you eat one of those big power shots, it almost evens out.
And a spinning fist. Klein has found her second wind.
Yep. Fight!
There's that pit bull style. She's getting fancy there, trying to fake the right hand and go with the left. Oi! Nice level changing.
Reminds you a little bit of the Dutch pit bull. Robin van Roosmalen. Okay. Same body style.
Very
hard
durable. Yeah.
The last time. Okay. The last time.
Walks around with a chip on their shoulder.
You find Klein moves a little bit more, where van Roosmalen, he ain't moving back. He ain't moving back.
Fight!
I like Tinchurina's knees. When Klein was coming in, she landed a few good ones. But maybe if she changed that knee to the head, she can get a little bit more damage.
Right to the body, left hook scores. And right now, Tinchurina is gonna need a knockdown in the final 49 seconds, or she will lose this fight. Not likely, Joe.
Nope, she looks great. I mean, I'm really impressed with her strike variety. I mean, we've seen her go with that right hand, low kicks, Superman, head kicks. Good combination work.
Can she compete at a high level in this very talented super bantamweight division we have at Glory?
Well, it seems like it. I mean, she's showing a great performance. I know this is Tinchurina's pro debut, but I mean, right now, Klein's looking really impressive.
Love to see her in there against someone like a JD Menezes.
Oh yeah, that'd be perfect.
Thanks. 10 seconds to go in our opening contest. Blood now again.
Oh, there's that front kick.
Big shot landed there for Tinchurina. And a final punch landed for Klein, who feels she's got this one won. She should be happy.
Absolutely. I mean, I know she was surprised that Glory gave her the call because she was a little inactive, but she looks great. I mean, this is one of the best, you know, debut performances I've seen from the super bantamweight division.
As for the future of Almira Tinchurina,
I mean, I think there's potential. I think she's got the body frame, but she fought a really experienced fighter. I mean, you got to think, you know, the record of Klein is 29-12, where this is her pro debut. So maybe it was a little bit much for her to for her debut, but if anything, she's going to get better. She's going to get used to this style of fight. Remember, Muay Thai is a little bit slow, where it's this pace, and Klein just did the total opposite. She pressured, she got aggressive. So, I mean, now that she understands the rules and the style, I think it's just going to make her a better fighter.
Waiting for the official scores to come in. We're going to remind you that later tonight, world title battle, Petch versus Adamczyk for the featherweight title. Also, Gregorian versus Bates, number 2 versus number 9. That's all coming up later tonight on Glory 75 Utrecht. 1 month from now, we will be just south of the border in Belgium at Antwerp. And what a showdown this one's going to be. Doumbé versus Groenhart. They will complete their trilogy, and a lot of bad blood between these guys.
Oh yeah, there was that sit down we had and just the trash talking. I'm loving it. I mean, these guys are really hyping the fight, and there's a lot of tension, so let's get it on.
And also, Badr Hari returns Saturday, June 20th in Rotterdam, but who will he be fighting? That question will be answered a couple of hours from now during Glory 75. A lot of big names want this fight.
Oh, absolutely. Everybody wants this fight. Man, I'll take it. Get me on there.
Really? You versus Botter, why not? Here are the highlights from our opening bout, Klein versus Tincherina.
Yeah, Lorena Klein, I was really impressed with the way she came forward in that pit bull style. And, you know, she lived up to her nickname. Good power, good level changing, and really good combinations when she really got on the inside. You saw her mix levels really well. She had to eat a few shots to get on the inside, but when she did some good work. And you saw her attack well with her low kicks. And then she would mix her overhand right well. But everything was power. Everything was straightforward. And she wanted a good finish. And so a lot of those right hands landed, and Tincherina just took it and continued to walk forward, where Tincherina tried to stay long, especially in this third round. She used her jabs, mixed her front kicks, tried to attack with her knees, but Lady Putbull just walked through it, landed some spinning back fists, and did everything she could to get a solid win. There's that front kick she ate to get on the inside, but there ain't no slowing down for Lady Putbull.
Tim Hughes now with the decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 3 rounds of kickboxing, we go to the judges' scorecards. Here are the scores now from our 5 ringside judges. One scores it 29-28. The other 4 have it 30-27. A unanimous decision. All for your winner, Lorena Klein.
All right, I'm here with a very happy and emotional Lorena Klein. How are you feeling after that performance?
I'm really emotional. I trained really hard for this fight, really, really hard. And before this match, I told myself I deserve to stand here, to fight here, and I deserve to win. I started to warm up in the 3rd round, so if there was a 4th round, I didn't care. I was just getting warmed up, and if I can say, I'm really happy. And my trainer still stands there. He says, if you win, I'm walking away because my job is done. But I want to thank my team, because without those guys, I couldn't do it. And my family also, I really deserve this win. Thank you.
I thought you looked incredible with your pressure, your performance. I mean, how do you rate your performance? Is this the type of fighter you are?
To be honest, I'm sure I can do a lot better. And what I said, like the 3rd round, I was getting warmed up a little bit. I know I'm not getting my rhythm in fighting. I'm going to be much, much, much more better than this performance, I know for sure. But I enjoyed every second of it.
I know that walkout scared everybody. I mean, I'm sure your coaches are scared. What's going through your mind? I saw that little step. I was scared you're going to hurt yourself, but you made it successfully.
Yes, I did. Before I fight, I asked to look at the stage, but this is my entrance, you know, and I always be entering the ring like this because this is me. And today I didn't do as much show as I used to be, like the heel kicks and stuff. But he did a good job, so it was an unanimous decision, and I'm happy.
Well, you're an exciting fighter, and there's a lot of exciting matchups. Let's hear Utrecht for your winner, Lorena Klein.
Great to see that smile on her face. She said she trained twice a day for 7 weeks, no days off. Said, I've never been in this kind of shape in my life. I'm giving Glory all I've got. Congratulations to her on her 30th career win. Coming up later tonight, the featherweight championship of the world is on the line. Petch Panmaron versus Sergey Adamchuk.
Our second preliminary bout of the evening, 3 3-minute rounds in Glory's featherweight division. And first to make his way to the Glory ring, here comes Antonio Campoy.
El Flamenco, that's the nickname of Antonio Campoy. He plays flamenco-style music on his guitar. He's very talented. You can look up some of his YouTube videos. But his real passion, he says, is fighting in the ring.
Yeah, and he's a spectacular fighter. And, I mean, he did make his debut. He fought a tough River Daz. But if you give someone like Campoy space, he's going to be spectacular. He's all about his kick arsenal. He's got good spin kicks and a very entertaining style. So we got to see how we can put that together here tonight.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome his opponent, Bowie Zonnefeld.
Bowie Zonnefeld coming in on back-to-back wins, said he's going to employ his Dutch style. Joe, going to focus on the low kick.
Yep, it's all about forward, constant pressure. And I mean, he's going to keep attacking with those legs. He says he's got a really good chin. And, you know, he's still new in his professional career. He's only got 6 pro fights. So he's taking on a big task in someone like Campoy.
Here's our tale to take for our second fight of the night. Bowie Zonnefeld and Antonio Campoy. Zonnefeld, 24 years old. Campoy is 30. They're both 5'9", but it'll be the Spanish fighter who will have a 3-inch reach advantage.
With professional experience, a 20-fight edge for the Spaniard, Antonio Campoy. And you can see he's got a 20% KO ratio, and a lot of that comes from that spin kick, so keep an eye on it.
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, we're scheduled for 3 3-minute rounds in Glory's featherweight division. And introducing first, standing on my left and fighting out of the black corner, he is a WKN Spanish and European champion. As a professional, 20 wins with 2 losses, 4 bouts scored even, and 4 career knockouts. At 5'9" tall, 1.75 meters, he weighed in at an even 142 pounds, 64.4 kilograms. Fighting tonight out of Barcelona, Spain, ladies and gentlemen, introducing Antonio El Flamenco Campoy. His opponent standing on my right and fighting out of the white corner, trained in karate and kickboxing. Now on a 2-fight winning streak, he will make his Glory debut tonight in Utrecht. As a professional, 3 wins with 3 losses. He stands 5'9" tall, 1.75 meters, and he weighed in at 142.9 pounds, 64.8 kilos. Fighting tonight out of Beverwijk, the Netherlands. Ladies and gentlemen, here is Bowie Zonnefeld. And the third man inside the Glory ropes, your referee, Niels Bergson.
Okay, gentlemen, this is a Glory fight. 3 rounds of 3 minutes. We both know the rules, so make it a good and clean fight. Shake hands if you like. Go back to your corner.
Well, as we know, the coronavirus is impacting all sorts of things around the world, including this fight. Meng Gaofeng of China was supposed to fight against Antonio Campoy, but he stayed home because of the coronavirus breakout. Bowie Zonneveld stepped in on 2 weeks' notice, and here we go, and he came out firing, Joe.
He's scrapping. I mean, that's the strategy. You can't give Campoy space, so expect Zonneveld to keep that pressure on.
Zonneveld very, very confident heading into this fight. Said he's watched Campoy's bouts, sees nothing special, and thinks he's going to knock him out.
You see Campoy already, his kicking. Like, even from close range, he's able to get those head kicks. So Zonneveld needs to stay tight, stay close. Ooh, good right hand there from Campoy.
Followed up with a jab as well. Joe in boxing.
Oh,
nice high kick there from Campbell, who's going right after Zonneveld.
Yep, it's all about that kicking arsenal. And he's mixing it well with his punches. Touches upstairs and the head kicks coming from nowhere.
Split the guard with the right hand, did Antonio.
Fight! Break! Fight!
I like that. Campoy's not moving. He's staying in the pocket. And he's embracing the grind.
Campoy, at least thus far, showing he might be just a class better than Zonneveld.
Yeah, the combination work right now from Campoy is really nice. I love the way he's mixing that head kick off of the punches. And he's mixing low kicks, and that's going to set up the head kick.
How about a double inside left low kick by Campoy?
Yeah, and he's just mixing it. It's incredible. And he's flowing with it so nicely, so clean. Sharp technique.
We should boom some flamenco music over the speakers. He looks like he's dancing in there.
That head kick's close.
Fight.
Not a lot of head movement by Zonneveld either. Just stands there like a post and takes the shot.
Yeah, he's trying to throw these counter hooks, but he's missing too much. Ooh, there's the spin kicks I'm telling you to watch for. Oi! I'm scared there. I thought it was a knockdown.
There's the high kick off the glove.
It's been a while. I want to see some knockouts and knockdowns. Getting too hyped up.
Campoy looks like a world beater in there so far here in round one. Just the mix that he's showing.
And the level changing, too.
You saw his coach, Jordy Calvet, barking instructions there in the corner in Spanish, of course.
Holy guys. Fight!
Oh, followed up. Spinning back fist, high kick. Campoy fighting like a video game character.
Yep. You give him space, it's dangerous.
But can he do this for three rounds?
I think so. As a featherweight, this is his style. He's used to training with a lot of kicks. So I'd say yes.
There's a left hand that lands for Zonneveld.
But Campoy, what I like is how he throws that head kick so fast and so close. It comes from nowhere. You have Zonneveld from the Netherlands. You know, began training karate and judo at a young age, which just shows his confidence in martial arts, signature strike, the low kick. He started that round really well with it, but he needs to continue with it and keep that pressure on. El Flamenco, former WKN European champion. He does have a lot of experience outside of Glorian. I mean, a professional record of 20 wins and only 2 losses. So we're seeing good, spectacular offense from him tonight. So
Campoy showed some good stuff in round one.
Very good, and I think it all stems from these combinations that he uses his punches to set up the kicks, and especially with Zonneveld not knowing what strikes come in or at what level, because we've seen Campoy attack the leg and go head kicks.
And Joe, you said it earlier, and you were right. It looks like Zonneveld is just waiting to try and catch Campoy with a hook.
Yeah, I mean, if anything, that's your best strategy when you fight a wild guy. If you're going to sit in the pocket, take 3-4 shots, you might as well counter with a big punch at the end.
This is where Campoy does not want to be in the corner. That guy who's loading up with his hooks. All 5 judges give it to the Spaniard.
Yeah, I see Zonneveld leading with his punches, but when he was going more low kick based, I liked it.
The last time we saw Campoy was in the ring against the unbeaten River Daz. What's the difference in that performance to this one? It looked like he was jumping there.
Well, I just think it's stylistically. River Daz is good with his footwork, good angling, where Zonneveld is more of that straightforward style, so that really works well for Campoy.
Fight.
Really impressed by what we're seeing so far.
Even for Zonnefeld, I wouldn't mind him maybe throwing a head kick, because you see Campoy's head really dip off when he's trying to punch. So maybe surprising Campoy with a head kick could work for him.
There's some knees now from Bobby Zonnefeld.
No holding. Fight. Break. Okay. Fight.
You have Campoy really crashing the distance now.
Campoy born and raised in Barcelona, Spain. Always wanted to be a fighter. Just didn't know what it would do or what kind of fighter he would be. Would it be judo, taekwondo? He found kickboxing and fell in love. Now he's back for his second fight here in the organization.
No holding.
A lot of his spin kicks came from his taekwondo background. Started at 4 years old. Did it for many years before transitioning to kickboxing. So lifelong martial artist for Campbell.
You have a double black belt in taekwondo, do you not?
I got my second degree black belt before I started kickboxing. So we have very similar backgrounds when it comes to martial arts. And he started at age 4 too, so same time.
Well, Zonnefeld's showing he's got a lot of heart, that's for sure. You see the welts on his body, on his face.
Fight!
There's a little headbutt there that Campoy wasn't happy with.
Fight!
Oh, nice knee there for Campoy.
And he followed it with a nice right punch. He just doesn't stop after the knee.
You know, Zonnefeld talked about getting a knockout. Campoy is looking more and more like he can score one, and he's not known for power, only 4 KOs and 20 wins.
And he's just staying in the pocket, which is cool because he's dominating on the outside. But it looks like he's really trying to land those knees.
Trying an axe kick, gotta be careful. Leaves yourself very vulnerable when you throw that.
Fight! Time!
Another solid round for El Flamenco. The 2020 season continues from the Netherlands later tonight. Glory 75, the professor, puts his 8-fight winning streak on the line, his 4th title defense against number one ranked Sergey Adamchuk. Also, Harut Gregorian, Yusri Belgari, Tijani Beztadi, all looking to get back in title contention. Glory 75 later tonight.
Really liking the way Campoy's mixing things up. And this round, it seemed all about close range, using his knees. And that's that little combination I like when he went right knee, right hand. Very sneaky, unorthodox.
Well, Joe, Campoy has obviously won the first 2 rounds pretty easily. If you're his trainer, his coach, how hard are you pressing him to go for the gusto in round 3?
Well, I feel he has to stay busy because that's what's keeping Zonnefeld off of him. So I still think he's got to fight the same fight. He hasn't really been hurt the 2 rounds.
Quick.
Good shot there from Campoy.
Yep. It was interesting because round 2, Campoy was about the knees. And in round 3, he's going back to those punch-kick combinations.
Quick.
The knees have been scoring well. Oh, nice spinning back fist for Campoy and another knee up top.
Quick.
Yeah, strike variety.
Fight.
Well done from Campoy. Oh.
Still has to be careful. Those hooks are coming fast and furious when he throws them.
Yeah, Zonnefeld still has power. That's what I'm saying. When Campoy dips his head off center line, sometimes that's it. That's what I'm saying. When he dips off, there was Zonnefeld landing a nice left hook.
Quick. Stand back.
Zonnefeld told us in the fighter meeting, even though I took this on 2 weeks' notice, I will never stop going forward. I won't give up.
Like I mentioned, he only has 6 professional fights against someone with 22.
Fight.
So it's a little bit more difficult for him, but he's eating it.
26 pro fights, actually, for Campoy.
Oh, he has four draws there.
Ooh, and a nice hook there connected for Zonnefeld to the body.
Quick.
One of his better strikes tonight.
Oh, nice right hand there from Campoy.
Break. Fight. Break. Watch out there.
Yep, has to hit the glove.
Fight.
That spinning back fist was elbow and forearm.
Break. Step back.
Minute 15 to go here. Third and final round. Our second prelim bout. Bowie Zonnefeld from the Netherlands taking on Spain's Antonio Campoy.
Break. Fight! Break! Step back. Fight! Watch out, head. Huh? Okay? Fight!
Whoa. Good right hand, Zonneveld. Can we have some late drama here at Utrecht with 40 seconds left?
Fight!
Zonneveld's right, though. He's tough.
Break.
He's not backing down.
Fight!
Oh.
Break, break.
The third round has been the best round for Zonneveld, but he needs a knockdown.
Break. Fight!
Boy.
Boy, I tell you what. Campoy is light on his feet. That's for
sure. All that flamenco dancing paid off.
Fight!
Great performance tonight from El Flamenco, Antonio Campoy, who seeks his first glory win in his second glory fight. Big celebrations in their corner with his head coach, Jordi Calvé.
You got to think it was a lot of pressure losing his debut, and you know it's a big relief to come here, get a good win. Now this is when they're learning. You got that first win, now he needs to keep building.
Well, it's not official yet, Joe, but I get your drift. We'll see the decision in just a minute, but we're all pumped already for what takes place next month down south in Belgium as it's Cedric Doumbé taking on Myrtle Grunhardt. Doumbé and Grunhardt, earlier this week, they sat down face-to-face for the first time since this fight was announced, and it was absolute fireworks. We're putting all the editing together. We'll have that for you on our YouTube channel soon, but it takes place Saturday, March 28th in Antwerp for the Welterweight Championship of the World. Now to highlights between Bowie Zonneveld and Antonio Campoy.
Antonio Campoy, all about spectacular offense, mixing his kicks, and really showing case in good boxing and good knees. And you just saw when he got comfortable and you give him range, he's gonna mix those kicks, whether they're spinning low or high. And in this fight here, we saw some improvements in his boxing. He was comfortable sitting on the inside, exchanging the big punches, but his combinations what made him so dangerous. The way he mixed the punches, kicks, and knees, and the levels, always keeping Zonneveld guessing. But you gotta give Zonneveld a lot of credit. You know, he took this fight on short notice. You know, he's the least experienced of the two with only 6 pro fights, but he came in, continued to eat shots, come forward, and really made it an exciting fight and made it tough on Campoy.
Tim Hughes with the decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, this bout goes the distance, so we go to the judges' scorecard. All 5 of our ringside judges see the bout and score the bout the same. 30-27, a unanimous decision, all for your winner, Antonio Campoy.
All right, I'm here with your winner, Antonio Campoy. You gotta feel good, man. You finally got your first glory win out of the way.
Habla español. ¿Cómo te sientes después de la primera victoria en Glory?
Bueno, muy muy contento, ya que era un rival muy complicado. Y bueno, hemos hecho la pelea que estábamos practicando. Y la verdad que muy contento.
He's really happy because he's training so much. And he said everything the coach has telling him, he did it. He executed. So he's very happy.
I mean, you came in, you showcased your good kicking, spectacular offense. Are you happy about your performance?
¿Estás contento con tu performance, con tu ataque?
Sí, la verdad que estoy muy contento, pero bueno, soy un chico muy exigente y la verdad que me gusta aprender poco a poco, de día a día y mejorar poco a poco, pero bueno, creo que he hecho una buena pelea.
Yes, I'm happy, but I'm a perfectionist. I want always be excellent and I'm going to train more and deliver more show, more spectacle for all the Glory fans.
Were you surprised that he was able to take some of those shots and keep coming forward?
¿Te ha impresionado que siguiera yendo para adelante después de las manos que se ha comido?
Bueno, la verdad que ya lo habíamos estudiado y sabíamos que era un chico fuerte. Ya ha estado en Holanda otra vez entrenando y yo creo que es la cuna del kickboxing, ¿no? Holanda. Y la verdad que me esperaba el chico ya bastante fuerte.
Yes, we were prepared. I've been training in Holland. I know we knew what he was a Dutch style guy, always coming forward, pressure. So I was expecting that and I've been ready and I delivered.
When you look at the featherweight division, where do you think you stay in that?
¿Qué piensas ahora de la división? ¿Dónde crees que estás?
Bueno, yo pienso que estoy. He llegado muy poquito, hace muy poquito, y estoy de los más abajo, pero bueno, trabajaré para intentar subir poco a poco.
I'm a humble guy. I know I'm a good fighter, and I want to go step by step and climbing up the rankings in Glory.
All right, congratulations on your win. Let's hear it for Antonio El Flamenco Campoy.
He seems to have improved leaps and bounds since his last fight against River Daz. And according to his interview right there, Campoy thinks he can get even better going forward. Love to see that. Still to come tonight, the featherweight championship of the world on the line. It's our headliner, Glory 75 Utrecht, Petch versus Adamczyk. That's later tonight. And then next month, Joe, you're back with me, Doom Bay and Myrtle Grunhardt.
Yeah, that's fireworks. And I mean, I think the pre-hype, the trash talking, the back and forth, the history, just makes this fight that much more exciting. And I will be surprised if it goes the full distance, put it that way.
Well, Doom Bay has promised a second round KO. We'll see if he comes through on that one. And then later here tonight, we know Badr Hari is returning Saturday, June 20th in Rotterdam, but who will he face? That answer will come your way right before our main event. We will learn who Badr Hari's opponent will be. All right, Joe, two down, nine to go. Of all those nine fights, which one are you most excited to see here tonight?
Ooh. Well, I'm excited to see that Bruno Gazzani and Hendu fight because both guys are all about forward pressure. There's going to be a lot of volume between the two, and I think we have a future lightweight contender in that fight.
Harut Gregorian, Jamie Bates.
Of course. I mean, that's the welterweight division, and I said it time and time. I think the welterweight division is the one of the best here, so there's Campoy behind. I'm just excited.
All right, so we're about 10 minutes away. It'll be the Glory Super Fight Series on UFC Fight Pass in the United States. Coming your way at the top of the hour. He's Joe. I'm Todd. We'll see you then.